When the 11th of 90, we got to bust some nuts. I know in about 11 and a half days, I haven't been busting any nuts. Yes, you guys, we're getting up there in the days, and yes, it's getting harder. The random boners are back, and it's getting harder. Yeah, man, I want to talk about this. First of all, I'm talking about some my guy Fitz Brown, aka 24/7 Betterment, talked about in his videos about how he relapsed, how he was. Some girl, he was on the website, whatever he was on, and you know, the little chat boxes pops up, and the girl's like, well, Angela's 5 miles away, type in the search box to speak with her. Those, we all know that stuff, the little text boxes that popped up with the fine-ass girl and that's typing, and it's like, Alexis is typing, and she's typing, so where do you live? You want to come and meet up? So, like, those chat boxes like that, and he mentioned how he was chatting with her, and how she was like, I forgot what he mentioned about, he mentioned, but it's like, you know, those little webcam model girls, that bullshit. But I remember, I seen somebody, a comment in his video, somebody was like, he knew somebody who, or he heard about, I forgot what the guy said, but somebody, apparently, they watched one of those videos, and like, he was masturbating in the video to like the live cam girl, and she said that she would record him, I guess after he bust that nut. She said that she was recording him, and that if he doesn't send her some money, she's gonna post the video of him masturbating to all of his friends on Facebook. That's some scary shit, I ain't gonna lie to you. If that happened to me, I don't know what I would do. I'd probably delete all instances of social media. I'd probably delete all my YouTube videos. I'm lying right now, but I'll be really, really nervous, because that's some shit that you can't. We all know people masturbate. A lot of people masturbate. All your friends and your friends list probably masturbate, but it's still kind of weird to have somebody literally send a video anonymous to all your friends list of you beating up. That's not something I would want to be caught. Well, first of all, I would probably be covering my rep. I don't know. That's some scary shit right there, but I brought it up to talk about, like, you know, we get tested on this NoFap street. The higher you go, which generally when you get the double digits, you start feeling this. It usually happens like a couple of days before you hit with that strong urge. It's like you get tested spiritually. And what I mean is, you start having dreams, weird ass dreams about. I mean, I told you guys, I said this many times. I had a dream about one time I was in the van beating up in the morning, and I woke up. I was like, damn, that shit was weird. Why else do you think that you have people? We have dreams like that. People. Leave your story in the chat about like weird dreams, stuff like that you had, or weird like instance like that. But I feel like certain instances happen in life that test us, and then when we end up like certain things come up where we get like stressed, like maybe a car tire will be flat or something will happen to where we get like really frustrated and depressed, and we end up relapsing. And then after this happened to me a couple of times, like after you relapse or bust that nut, something good will happen. Like some you realize that you bust that nut too wasn't that bad. You be thinking like, damn, I bust that nut of that, and then next thing you know, like you don't I don't know. You realize that, damn, if I just did this or did that or did this, what I just relapsed for wasn't that bad. But then I think it usually happens after, like, you want a really good streak, a pretty good streak. You feel pretty good about yourself. You feel pretty confident. Then you start getting those urges. And I feel like then, like, leading up to the relapse, you start, like, having a weird dream. You start feeling, like, more depressed, more upset, anxious. No. You're feeling confident. You're really confident. But then, soon, you get hit with, like, something bad would happen. You be telling yourself, damn, I feel really good on this streak. Something bad would happen to you. Like, not maybe anything catastrophic, but something that's gonna piss you off. Maybe you failed a test or something like that. Oh, you forgot to do an assignment, and you just feel like really depressed, really down, so you end up relapsing. But then afterwards, like, the teacher would be like, I'm gonna give you guys a chance to make up the test, or I'm giving out 20 points of extra credit if you do this, do that. And you're like, damn, man, I busted a nut because I did bad in the test. And then literally the next day, the teacher's like, you can make it this time. Something like that happens, and he's like, damn, man, I relapsed for that, because of that. Then the next day, something good happens to where it's like, well, damn, I really relapsed because of that. But in reality, if I would just kept on going, it turns out things would have been okay. So I feel like whenever you get urges, like, especially like things like pop-ups, like, we know We've all had this before, like on Instagram or Twitter, you get those little followers from like the chicks, like the really fine ass chicks. They have like I don't know, like 25, like one follower, and all the pictures be like really, really sexual. You had one of them chicks, the one of them profiles like follow you out of nowhere, and it's like, what is this person following me for? And it's like, it just tests you, man. Like, you log on YouTube one time, and you see like a really sexual like thumbnail. It's like, damn, man, I want to click on this video. And it's always when you're like in a two-week mark. Is that when you're on like day three? You on like day 20, 25, you and your best trick ever. You go on YouTube, you saw a sense of like sexual like thumbnails, like best kiss scenes and movies. You like, oh, I wanna watch this. You start seeing things like that, it's like, damn, man, you wanna click on it. You start thinking about it, fuck. Then you end up beating off to it, it's like, then afterwards you're like, damn, man, I see what happened there. So just know that your mind, the longer you go, I'm gonna say it over and over again, the longer you go on NoFap, the more your mind's gonna try to find different ways to get it fixed. Your mind's gonna be like, well, damn, this dude isn't giving us what we want, so we're gonna have to find other ways to get that release from. So that's why you start fantasizing more. You start having really bad sexual thoughts, and you don't even notice it, but you're releasing dopamine when you're fantasizing and having these thoughts. And you just think to yourself, like, it's natural. I'm thinking about with sex with real women, but what you didn't realize is you still release dopamine, and you're trying to get your brain a break from dopamine in the first place with NoFap. So you really slowing down your progress, and then you just speed. Then you just, one day you're gonna wake up one day with the strongest urge, you're gonna bust a nut. So yeah, we have to really recognize the science of, like, you know, I'm not giving my brain something that it really wants, that addiction part of my brain. So it's gonna look for other avenues to fill that. So you have to really be careful of that and not give into it, because once you do, you're gonna be like, damn, man, if I would have just did this, I would have avoided that. But anyway, I'll see you guys soon for day 12, and as always, don't relapse.